Hello and welcome to Devil's Advocate. They used to call him the rising star of Tamil politics. Today they consider him the great enigma. And the reason is his support for the LTTE and his changing political connections. Here to talk about both of them is the General Secretary of the MDMK, Vaiko. Mr. Vaiko, let's start with Sri Lanka. Now that Prabhakaran has publicly declared that the ceasefire agreement has become defunct, do you believe that Elam is the only solution?
This is my consistent view for many years. Elam is the only solution which could satisfy the aspirations of the Tamil people there.
And do you support military means armed struggle to secure Elam?
Through the world, people liberated their homeland only through armed struggle other than India.
Is there any limit to the armed struggle in your eyes that you would accept? Or when it's war, is everything fair?
In war and love, there are no strict rules. Everything is fair. When victory is achieved, mostly the people and the world will congratulate and welcome. This has happened in Cuba, this has happened in Vietnam, this has happened in many other countries.
Many people who are perhaps supporters of the LTTE draw a line at what they call killings. Would you draw that line or would you say, no, they misunderstand?
See, I am totally committed to peace, to peaceful means. But at the same time, we should not forget the fact. There in the island of Sri Lanka, killings have been done by the state racist government. So extrajudicial killings, killing the innocent civilian population. That is why the gun, the LTTE, the Tamil youth have taken has protected the population.
In other words, if the government does killings, then the LTTE has a right to do the same thing too.
In what way they could face them? Only through weapons they could face them.
In a statement on your website, you say India should not jeopardize the unity, integrity and sovereignty of the island. But if Sri Lanka can't preserve its unity and Tamils there achieve their goal of Elam, we should not at any cost help the Sri Lankan government. Does that mean that India should not assist the partition of the island, but if partition becomes inevitable, India must equally not stand in the way?
I have been misquoted. I never stated that India should try to protect the unity and integrity of that island.
But this is on your website.
No.
I'm quoting from your website.
This is wrong. My view, because throughout our party history, we have clearly stated that the fate or the destiny to be decided by the Tamil people there. And we have no authority to dictate terms to maintain the unity and integrity. India has no right. In that case, how Bangladesh was evolved.
Okay, so the statement on your website you're saying to me, and it's still there even today, is wrong.
It should be corrected. It's wrong.
It should be removed. It's wrong.
It will be modified.
The same statement also says the island of Ceylon consists of two nations, the Tamil and the Sinhala. If the Tamils of Ceylon are a separate nation, where does that leave the Tamils of India? Are the Tamils of India a separate nation too?
No, it is totally different. And when Bangladesh was carved out, whether the Bengalis in West Bengal, do they claim for a separate Bengal? So we should not equate both India and Sri Lanka. There, the Tamils have been subjugated for decades as a slave race.
So the Tamils...
Here, Tamils in India, we are equal citizens with others.
So that's the big difference between the Tamils of India and the Tamils of Sri Lanka.
Totally.
The Sri Lankan Tamils are an independent nation. The Indian Tamils are part of the bigger, wider, greater Indian nation.
We are part of the subcontinent as a nationality, Tamil nationality. But we are committed to the unity and integrity of India.
All right. On the 21st of August, you said in Chennai, I am willing to be imprisoned all my life or even face the gallows for supporting the LTTE. Did you mean that or was that just loud talk?
It has come from the bottom of my heart, from
you mean
the core
it?
Of my heart.
You mean it?
I mean it.
You are prepared to face death for the LTTE?
For the cause of the Tamils which is represented by the LTTE. You should understand that. For the cause of the Tamils who have been suffering, who have been subjugated all these years.
I understand that completely. In which case, explain this to me. How do you account for the fact that the two parties that you support in Chennai and in Delhi both regard the LTTE as terrorists? Jayalalitha, your ally in Chennai, as recently as the 12th of September, said to PTI, the AIADMK will not support a terrorist organization like the LTTE. Why is she your ally?
See, political parties have got their own individual approach for every problem. Otherwise, there is no need for separate political parties.
Who's more important to you, LTTE or Jayalalitha?
See, AIADMK, they are entitled to have their own views. MDMK is entitled to have our own views. But doesn't mean we have got differences in our alliance.
So you've agreed to disagree over the LTTE?
Pardon?
You agree to disagree over the LTTE?
See, we agree to disagree on certain issues. In that case, in any coalition, every political party is having their own individual identity and views.
I understand. Your case with Jayalalitha is you agree to disagree. The problem is you also support the Congress in Delhi, and that is a party that also considers the LTTE to be terrorists. And in the case of Congress, they are not asking for your support. You're thrusting it on them.
I am not thrusting on them. We are not thrusting on them. We have not got, we don't enjoy any ministerial berths. And when Mr. Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh requested me to continue in the alliance, we are continuing.
In other words, you're saying to me that you're continuing in the alliance at the specific request of the Prime Minister?
Because we decided to join the alliance. And today, we want to continue in the UPA.
You want to
with
continue?
With self-respect, we continue. And we have been...
This is very important. Do you want to continue, or has the Prime Minister asked you to continue? Which is it?
We want to continue in the UPA, provided we are properly respected and given due regard.
But you're prepared to do that at the cost of the fact that the UPA as a whole, and Congress in particular, considers the LTTE to be terrorists. You don't. So you've sacrificed the LTTE to be able to support the UPA.
Why should I? Whether the communists have sacrificed all their ideology to support the UPA government, they are extending support from outside. We are also extending support from outside.
So
we are not in the cabinet.
All right. Explain this to me. What does Sonia Gandhi make of the fact that in public speeches in Chennai, you publicly eulogize, you shower praise on Prabhakaran, but in her eyes, he is the principal accused in the Rajiv Gandhi assassination case? How does she handle this, Sonia Gandhi?
You see, on this issue, it is a very emotional issue. And this issue doesn't come in the way of our cordiality. And therefore, we...
So once again, you've agreed to disagree?
Yes.
What about the fact that on your website, there is a statement which clearly suggests that Rajiv Gandhi in 1989, during the run-up to the India-Sri Lanka Accord, deliberately misled Prabhakaran. He even entrapped Prabhakaran. Is Sonia aware that your website says that?
I don't know whether they are aware or not, but what I have stated is part of history.
And you stand by it?
I stand by it.
And yet you're still prepared to support Congress as well?
Yes.
So there's a contradiction?
There is no contradiction. That is why I ask you whether the left parties do hold the same views, ideology of the Congress party.
So the
which
left
is heading the UPA government?
The left is the precedent you're following because they
not only the left, whether all the other constituents of UPA have got the same ideology and identical views on every aspect. This is my question.
All right.
Whether the parties, constituent parties of UPA, which are enjoying the ministerial berths, do they have the same yardsticks and approach to every problem? Like Congress?
And if they don't, then the MDMK can follow suit and also have contradictions inherent in its approach. All right.
We maintain our integrity, individuality and self-respect.
Let me then talk to you about your individuality. Let me talk to you in a sense about what you call your self-respect. I want to explore with you your personal connection with the LTTE. This August, speaking in the Tamil Nadu Assembly, Chief Minister Karunanidhi publicly said that in 1989, when Rajiv Gandhi had asked him to undertake a mission to Sri Lanka to try and sort out the Sri Lankan Tamil problem, you, Vaiko, thwarted his mission because you went secretly and illegally to Sri Lanka yourself. And then Mr. Karunanidhi also said that your secret mission had endangered the lives of the Indian peacekeeping forces. Do you put the LTTE ahead of India?
The biggest bluff, Dr. Karunanidhi stated, because before he met Rajiv Gandhi, I already proceeded to Sri Lanka.
So Dr. Karunanidhi was lying, so to speak. He was lying.
Utter lie, utter falsehood.
Total lie.
Bluff.
You are actually using the word lies.
Utter lie. I can prove it with authenticity.
So you did not undermine either the peace mission that he was supposed to undertake or endanger the lives of Indian forces?
It was the biggest bluff, he stated, that Rajiv Gandhi asked him to go to Sri Lanka, to particularly
Bombay. Rajiv Gandhi made no such request of him.
He never made such a request.
How do you know that?
In that case, he would have stated long back. I know what was going on there. It is a total bluff to mislead the people of Tamil Nadu.
In 1993, Jayalalitha, when she was chief minister, had a letter sent to Karunanidhi to forewarn him that the LTTE were planning to assassinate him. And the letter also claimed that the reason was that the LTTE wanted to promote your career. Is there more to your relationship with the LTTE than meets the eye?
This is totally wrong.
It's another lie?
Yes, because an unconfirmed report of the intelligence wing was sent to Tamil Nadu government from the Union government. That message was passed to Dr. Karunanidhi. He could have simply stated, I don't believe this cock and bull story.
So he's making politics out of it?
Yes, sir.
People in India, and many of them in Tamil Nadu itself, say that today the LTTE has become an obsession for Vaiko. It's become an irrational commitment. It's become his blind spot.
Not at all. I have been supporting the cause of the Tamils because they have been suffering like anything. I am concerned about the plight of the Tamils of the island. And they are represented only by the LTTE there.
When newspapers in India and many police sources say that the LTTE has links with ULFA, not just political links, but perhaps financial links, and maybe even military links, do you think it's right that you should support an organization that is
It is a total lie.
It's a lie?
It is a total lie.
How do you know?
What proof they have stated so far? Who stated?
Let me put a blunt question to you. Are you in touch with Prabhakaran today?
Not in touch today.
So then it in which case it could be correct that Prabhakaran and the LTTE are supporting ULFA. How do you know it's a lie?
No, they don't. Because I know what is going on in India. They don't support the LTTE ULFA. They don't have any connections with ULFA.
Do you have any reservations about your support for LTTE? Is it an unconditional support?
Why should there be a condition or non-condition?
Because many people in India feel worried about your support. Many people in Tamil Nadu feel worried. Your own ally Jayalalitha, your own ally Congress have concerns. Are you not worried about their concerns?
See, people have understood me and my sincere support for the cause of the Tamils. Madam Jayalalitha also knows my real concern for the Tamils. So there is no misunderstanding.
So they've accepted Vaiko and his support for the LTTE.
There is no misunderstanding.
In that case, let's take a break. I want to come back and talk about your political connections. Have people misunderstood you? Or are you in fact seeking allies for reasons that they don't understand? We'll be back in a moment's time. See you after this. Welcome back to Devil's Advocate and an exclusive interview with the General Secretary of the MDMK, Vaiko. Mr. Vaiko, let's turn to your constantly changing political commitments, what the press calls your flip-flops. I'm going to ask you a blunt question. Are you an opportunist who seeks allies for personal gain and personal convenience rather than ideology?
I am committed to ideologies. And in India, political parties, new permutation combinations they make, and alliance they change, and DMK was with BJP, and they are with Congress. They opposed to Congress.
Okay, you say you're committed to ideology. Let me point this out. In 98 and 99, you were with the BJP and the NDA. In 2004, you were with Congress and the UPA. In 2006, you're with Jayalalitha and the AIA, DMK. Do you change political allies like the rest of us change clothes?
I am consistent in my political views and ideologies.
These are three changes in 8 years. 3 changes in 8 years.
Many political parties, they are compelled by circumstances to change sides. And here, the cadres and the rank and file, the entire party machinery, we decide in our general council, we discuss deliberately, we have deliberations. So collective decision we make in the party. Not I am not making any decision on my own. This is the views of my party.
It may well be a collective decision, but that doesn't make the decision more moral. Let me point out to you, in 2002, you called Jayalalitha a fascist. You said that she had a sadist mind. In 2004, you said this lady is trying to demolish all the cherished principles of the Dravidian movement. You, in fact, accused her of atrocities.
Let me finish. Congress.
And now,
how Dr. Karunanidhi attacked the Congress, how MISA was used against DMK, how DMK and Congress have joined hands.
But if other people are chameleons and don't have moral anchors, is there any reason for Vaiko to be a chameleon too and to change sides every time the wind changes?
No, not like that.
But you're doing it. You're doing it. In 2004, you said Jayalalitha was destroying the Dravidian movement. You accused her of atrocities. In 2006, you were campaigning to make her chief minister again. I mean, aren't you embarrassed by the political somersaults you take?
This is done according to the views of the cadres. And in political parties, when we make certain criticism...
To me, that sounds like a bad excuse. You're saying that I didn't decide to support her. My party insisted I supported her. In other words, you're blaming the cadres for
I also accepted the view as a correct decision.
And you're not embarrassed by the somersaults?
Why do you say? Then all the political parties in India are making somersaults.
So you're no better than anyone else?
Huh?
You're no better than anyone else?
Yes.
In 1993, when you first broke with the DMK, you publicly said it was in practically every newspaper in the country that what you didn't like was that they were promoting Stalin. You said you were against dynastic succession in political parties. Today, you're supporting the Congress, a party that is grounded in dynastic succession. Is there no consistency in your views?
You cannot equate a DMK with the Congress.
Why?
The Congress is not doing as the DMK is doing here. To promote their family interests, DMK is doing all these things.
You don't think Congress is promoting the family interests of the Nehru-Gandhi family?
I don't think
Grandfather, daughter, son,
so.
And maybe now
the next
heir. I don't
think so. Madam Sonia Gandhi refused the crown this time.
Let's come to your relationship with the DMK.
She did not accept the offer to become the Prime Minister.
And can you give me a guarantee she won't become the Prime Minister or her son won't become the Prime Minister after the next election?
Why should I give you a guarantee? What has happened, I am telling you.
And that you think is the big difference?
No, what has happened? She refused the crown of Prime Minister. You cannot equate the Congress with the DMK.
All right.
And the DMK, Karunanidhi is promoting his only family.
Take up the DMK. You broke with the DMK over a difference of 3 seats. Are your political commitments so fragile that over something as small and slender as 3 seats,
you can break with the party?
It was three seats?
Not only because of 3 seats, the way in which we were humiliated by the DMK for 2 years and the way in which the DMK committed a fraud using the strength of the MDMK to get ministerial berths in the UPA government.
If humiliation is what drove you out of the embrace with the DMK, how come humiliation didn't prevent you embracing Jayalalitha? She arrested you in 2002 under Porter. She held you in jail for 18 months. She even wanted to ban the MDMK. She humiliated you more.
DMK was about to be banned by the Congress, and the worst sufferings we had under Kindly listen my answer. How DMK joined hands with Congress? Out of what necessity DMK joined hands with Congress? Kindly tell me.
So political convenience and compulsion is more important than commitment and ideology.
In politics, there are no permanent friends, no permanent enemies.
Is there only permanent self-interest?
No. Permanent conviction for the cause of the people.
But you seem to identify the cause of the people with the AIA DMK at one occasion, DMK on the next occasion, Congress, and then with BJP. So it seems to me that your idea of the interest of the people keeps changing.
No, I have not changed my ideologies or conviction, whichever party I had alliance.
Are you a misunderstood man?
No, I am not misunderstood.
Are the press and the critics being unfair to you?
The press is very fair to me in Tamil Nadu, in Delhi. Press is fair to me.
Have I been asking questions that are misunderstanding you? Because I'm accusing you of being an opportunist.
I am not agitated about your accusation. But fair-minded people will judge with all fairness about my commitment to the ideologies.
Mr. Vaiko, it's only fair that I let you have the last word. A pleasure talking to you on Devil's Advocate.
Thanks.